Good morning from the Big Cypress. So this seems to be my go-to place during this virus situation that we're in. So I'm just very lucky to be able to come out here and hang out in the wilderness and photograph. So I came out here the other day with my wide-angle lens to get some landscape shots, and I ended up coming back again but bringing my macro lens with me because I saw all these interesting small things that I wanted to photograph. And so, you know, I thought I would talk about macro lenses today, specifically macro lens versus telephoto lens. And if you own a telephoto lens, you might be thinking, well, what do I need a macro lens for? Or maybe you're thinking about buying a macro lens and you're not quite sure if that's something you want to invest in. So so let's talk about the differences between those two and see if there's a place for each one in your nature photography. Okay, so first of all, with the telephoto lens, and this is a 70 to 400, these are great, obviously, because you can zoom in on faraway subjects and make them look really close in the frame. So they're great for wildlife. Now, what about those smaller subjects? What about, you know, something that's no more than an inch in size? You know, is the telephoto lens going to be able to capture that well enough? Or are you going to need a macro lens to do that? Okay, well, first of all, what is a macro lens? I always think of it as a specialty lens. A macro lens, when you are reading about macro lenses, you're always going to see this one-to-one magnification description. And what does that mean, one-to-one magnification? What they're talking about is that if you have you have a sensor inside your camera, and it has a certain size. If you're shooting a full frame, it's a 35 millimeter width sensor, and that's about an inch and a half. And this camera is a cropped sensor, APS-C. So it's a smaller sensor, and it is about 24 millimeters or about 0.9 inches. So when they talk about one-to-one magnification, what they mean is that with this particular camera here that has a 1 inch or slightly less wide sensor, I can photograph in focus, I can focus on it, a subject that is the same width of my sensor. So if I have a subject that is about 1 inch in width, that means that I can get close enough to it, focus on it, to fill the frame with that 1 inch subject, 1-to-1. Okay, so the macro lens, you're able to get that 1 inch subject to fill the frame, and even at 400 millimeters, your telephoto can't do that. And there's two reasons for that. The first one is that they're very different lenses in the first place. The macro lens allows a lot of magnification to happen. How it does that, I don't know, but it does. And the other reason, and this is the biggest one, is that it has a much smaller minimum focusing distance. So you can get really close to that subject and get it right in the frame. I did an experiment at home, and I'm going to show you what I did. And if you want to do the same thing, you can. What I did was, is I took a ruler and I set it on a table. And then I put my camera on a tripod at the same level as the ruler. And I started with the macro lens. So I focused on a piece of the ruler and focused on it. And then I moved the tripod closer, and I use autofocus, autofocused on it, moved it closer, autofocus, closer and closer. And I kept autofocusing until at some point I got close enough where I could no longer focus on it. Okay, so I backed off a little bit to get it back into focus. That distance, the distance between the sensor in my camera and the subject, the ruler, that distance is called the minimum focusing distance. Okay, and then also what probably makes more sense to us in the field is look at the distance between the end of my lens and the subject. So I'm working with about 9 to 10 inches there. That means I can get the lens as close as 9 inches to my subject. Now also look at the LCD here showing the part of the ruler that is in focus. Notice that it is about 7/8 of an inch within the frame. That's 1-to-1 magnification. Okay, so after that, I put the telephoto lens on the tripod and did the exact same thing, only this time at that distance that I had the macro lens focusing, I could not focus with the telephoto. It's all blurred. All right, so now what I had to do is I had to back up the tripod so that I had to keep going, testing autofocus, move it back, test autofocus, move it back, until finally I was able to focus on the ruler. By the time I got to that distance, I was approximately 4.5 feet away, the sensor to the ruler, about 4.5 feet away. And by the way, I had the telephoto lens set at about 180 millimeters, the exact same focal length as my macro lens. Look at the LCD panel. What you're seeing is the ruler, but now instead of 1 inch within the frame, you're looking at 6 inches. Well, I can zoom in. So I zoom in to 400. If I zoom in to 400, now look at the ruler on the LCD. You're seeing 3 inches instead of 1 inch. So there's an obvious difference between the telephoto and the macro lens. Okay, so I'm set up here to capture a close-up of a thistle, a purple thistle. I'm about, just guessing, maybe about 1.5 feet away from my subject. And because the macro lens is a prime lens, I can't zoom in and out. So that means that I have to move the tripod and move things around in order to get that thistle in the frame. Now, I don't want it to fill the frame. I want to have some breathing room around it. So, you know, so I back up the tripod enough to be able to do that and then get a nice frame on that. So now what I'm doing is I'm looking at the background. So when you're using a macro, remember, depth of field is not going to be as great as a telephoto lens or another type of lens. So you're going to have a very narrow depth of field. So I typically will use an aperture that'll give me a little more depth, but I don't want to get too far into the small apertures because I'll lose some sharpness with that. So I want to stay within that sharpness zone that I think is about 8 to 11. And the other thing is you have to think creatively about your depth of field. And so with the thistle, you know, it's very prickly and very sharp looking. I want to focus on a part of the thistle and let the remainder of it stay out of focus. And I just find that to be a very more pleasing composition. So I'm using an aperture of f8, and that'll get just enough of the thistle in focus that I like anyway. The other thing that you have to pay attention to is the background. And so I've got my camera set up so that it's high enough to point down towards my subject. What that means is I'm making the grasses the background. So there's no sky, there's no horizon line. And so everything that is behind the thistle is grass. Now the issue is that because of the magnification, you're gonna magnify everything, including your background. So you wanna make sure that your background is not too contrasty. So you don't want some object sticking out among all the others. And that object could be a piece of grass that's really lit up by the sun. So, you know, you can just walk over or kneel over, and just kind of remove anything that looks like it's going to stick out. Take a shot, take a look at it, And whatever's there that you don't want to be there, just go over there and remove it. Okay, so the other thing is, obviously, I have my camera on a tripod. And because everything is being magnified with this macro lens, you're gonna be prone to a little more shake. So the image stabilization system in my Sony camera is awesome. And the lens, the macro lens that I use, is really sharp. So when I put it on a tripod and everything is nice and steady and no movement, I can really, really get sharp images with that. So highly recommend that, you know, when you're getting this close with this much magnification on your subject, you really need to be using a tripod. Want to make sure that your autofocus is in exactly where you want the sharpness to be. So I use spot focus, and I focus on a very specific part of my subject. Okay, so now that I got my macro shot, let's see what it would look like if I used my telephoto lens. All right, I have my telephoto lens attached, and the first thing that happened is I had to back away from my subject, and now I am about almost 5 feet away from it. And even though I'm zoomed in to 400 millimeters, I cannot fill the frame like I did with my macro lens at 180 millimeters. And that has to do with two things. The minimum focus distance, or the working distance that I can get with that macro lens, is much, much shorter, allowing me to get much closer. But also, more importantly, is the magnification. I just don't have that as much with my telephoto. Okay, the other thing you can notice in that picture is, look at the background, how messy it is. I used the exact same aperture that I used with the other lens, and you can see that there's more depth of field there, so I'm getting more of the background in focus, and also more of the thistle is in focus, which may or may not be a good thing. Okay, so if you're thinking about purchasing a macro lens, there's a few things to consider. The biggest one is the focal length, and as far as I know, all macro lenses, or at least most of them, are prime lenses, so you have to settle on a specific focal length. This one is 180, and I purchased 180, which is, I think, one of the largest focal lengths. I'm not sure if they come any longer than that, is because I wanted to shoot more wildlife, and so I needed to keep some distance between me and the subject. I didn't want to scare them off by hovering on top of them, so I wanted that distance, and I still wanted that close-up magnified shot. But the most popular focal length seemed to be 90 to 105. Just remember that your minimum focus distance is going to be shorter with your shorter focal length. So if you go as small as a 50 or 60 millimeter, you're going to be able to get right on your subject, within an inch of that subject. You're not going to be able to do that with a bee or some kind of insect, but you will be able to do some cool macro shots with flowers and other, you know, close-up type inanimate objects. Now, is there a way to get around that with your telephoto? In a way, there is. You can get what are called extension tubes that you attach between your lens and your camera, and it basically just extends the lens beyond the sensor. And you can stack those as well. And that will help kind of magnify that image or that subject that you're trying to capture. Just be careful, because I bought extension tubes for that reason a while ago. And I don't know, maybe I just went cheap with it, but I found them to be very slow. And I didn't see the benefit of using them so much, so I never used them. But you can try it out, and you know, if it means the difference between maybe spending $100 versus $800, maybe it's worth it to invest in that. Okay, so in summary, the benefit of the macro lens is the extreme magnification, and also the minimum focusing distance being much, allowing you to get much closer to the subject. Now, just keep in mind these things when you are using a macro lens. One is you have less depth of field, so be very, very mindful of your background and also your focusing point on your subject. Make sure that you're paying attention to the light and if you're casting a shadow or not on your subject. And because of the magnification, you're going to have a chance of more shake. So if you can put it on a tripod, much better for you. I got to leave you with one more thing. I think probably the biggest advantage to having a macro lens is it just opens up a whole new world of photography for you. I think that is just one of the best things about nature photography is that it's just a constant discovery. So the macro is a wonderful way of doing that. There's something else about the macro lens that I have to share with you. You know, how many times do you take shots out there and you go home, you get them up on the monitor and you're like, oh, doesn't look like what I thought it was going to look like. You're kind of disappointed. With the macro lens is that I'm out here and I can't really see my images that well as I'm shooting them. And I go home and I'm looking at them on the monitor and more often than not, I'm looking at them going, wow, I didn't see that. It's really cool. That's the macro lens from my perspective.